touched him with that jab on that nose.
Oh, he caught it! It's right there! There it is! There it is! Here's Abbasov's opportunity, the high knee! Nakashima in trouble! Here comes the flurry! Here comes the swarm! Here comes Kiamrian Abbasov! Nakashima backed up for the first time! He was rattled! He was shaken! He's still shaken! Oh my! Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. Will Kiamrian go hammering early on with the hands? That's how he likes to throw the strikes. He comes in swarming, says Kiamrian Abbasov. Nakashima will take his time, already shooting in for singles and doubles. Wants the champion on his back. If there's one place a wrestler, no matter what wrestling style they are, never wants to be, it's on their back.
Good defense shown by Abbasov early. As Nakashima shot him for that takedown, Abbasov was able to defend.
Nakashima has never tasted defeat. He has figured out everybody. He was an LFA champion in the USA. He's come to one, he's remained undefeated, he's earned his title. And this is his chance to defeat an amazing champion.
Let's go!
A rampant performer in his first title defense. Abbasov, there will come a point you feel that the champ will pull the trigger. When will it be? You see that crouched stance, chin tucked, hands high from Nakashima. Trained for quite a while with the greatest kickboxer of all time, Giorgio Petrosian.
You can see Abbasov should have the advantage on the feet, especially in this early part of the match, but Nakashima has surprised us a lot of times. Every time he's been in there, he showcases different weapons in the stand-up. You can see Nakashima is slowly starting to dip his head to the wrong side of Abbasov as he throws him to the canvas. Abbasov is just so strong.
Look at the strength stakes you'd have to give Abbasov. There's a nice clipping left hook though from Nakashima. Drifts off counterclockwise, back to center circle. 3 minutes remains, first of five. Southpaw stance here from Nakashima, high kick. Solid start here from both men. 2009 National Wrestling Champion, James Nakashima. Multiple champion in Greco-Roman wrestling, Kiamrian Abbasov. And of course holds that most coveted title of all, the ONE Championship gold. This a more tentative start from Abbasov than we're used to seeing. He does have tremendous respect for the skill set of James Nakashima.
Yeah, he knows the wrestling of Nakashima is extremely dangerous. And he wants to keep this match on the feet and keep trying to see if he can touch up Nakashima. You can see the way Nakashima in that southpaw position is kind of shifting his head to the right side of Abbasov, which is a dangerous spot to put your head in. Abbasov will tee off on you if you give him the right opening.
What Abbasov wants to do is put his lead foot on the outside of James's lead foot to enable the right hand, which is public enemy number one of the southpaw. So look for Kiamrian to do that. Get his left on the outside of the right foot of James Nakashima. Jab two there from the champion. Beautiful round kick to the ribs there from Nakashima.
Nakashima did say earlier this week that he spent a lot of time circling to the safe side, as he calls it, the left side of Abbasov. Nice little shot on a single leg, easily defended by Abbasov.
Stuffs the takedown again, does Kiamrian Abbasov. That's okay, Nakashima will reset, figure out something else. Always thinking, very much a cerebral combatant is Nakashima as he goes to that back leg of the champion. Good overhand left being the power hand of the southpaw. That was perfectly timed from Mr. Perfect. With timing like that, Nakashima should be Swiss.
Nice left hand. You can see he has spent a lot of time working in his stand-up, but he's also gotten back to his wrestling roots as well. He had worked with three Division I wrestlers out of his camp, so he spent a lot of time out there at the lab working with a lot of high-level wrestlers, so he feels very confident going into this matchup, not just focusing on the striking, but developing an intensely well-rounded game. Let's see what he's like inside the clinch. He's got the underhook on the right side. He's trying to apply some shoulder pumps.
Nakashima staying heavy on the champion. Abbasov turns him. A little tango against the wall here.
Nakashima,
out of the two, is looks for the more takedowns in the opening round with the singles and doubles. Body clinch now turns the champion back against the wall. Little knee to the inside end of the round. James Nakashima, left hand cross inside leg kick. Now, Mitch, what problems present when you are competing if this is, we'll preface, if this is a broken nose for Abbasov?
It's going to really restrict breathing. He has to now breathe out of his mouth, which means he has to open his mouth up, which sets your jaw in a very awkward position, and it also enables you to get knocked out. But you also can't blow your nose as well, which is kind of just a habit when you get into the deep water of a match trying to blow out your nose. But you've got to be very cautious of that, and every time James Nakashima lands that left hand, that's going to...
And you see now Nakashima, as we said, a genius. The IQ is off the charts. He's going after the note.
To him. He is so articulate, and he communicates so well his game plan. He's a great interview.
Originally grew up as a fan of pro wrestling. His father got him into real wrestling. I'm glad he did. He conquered the wrestling world and now looking to conquer mixed martial arts and become the man, the champion in the welterweight division.
Little level change there, but Abbasov was able to use that overhook on his right side to keep him up. This is kind of rare territory because Nakashima is usually successfully completing these takedowns, and he's been stuck like three or four times now on his takedown attempts as Abbasov starts to
unload by picking him up. Don't grab the cage.
Have we
Let's
seen
go.
This one go to ground yet?
No, there hasn't been. Every single takedown attempt has been stopped.
Are you surprised we haven't seen anyone go to ground yet?
Not really. These are two very high-level wrestlers, and a lot of times when you see two high-level wrestlers compete, their grappling kind of nullifies each other, and we see a stand-up.
Uppercut nicely scooped in there from the champion, Abbasov. Jab out of southpaw stance for James Nakashima. Uppercut again from Abbasov. Bit of a bolo punch developing now. Maybe he senses a chink in the armor of Nakashima. It could be on the chin, through the guard, coming up with a diesel piston of an uppercut. There's another one from Abbasov. Is there an opening there, Dragon?
Yeah, Abbasov needs to be a little bit more active because you can see in the first part of that match, Nakashima was getting very aggressive, pushing forward, looking for that left hand again. But now Abbasov has found a chink and he's starting to come underneath with that uppercut. And watch, let's see if Nakashima can figure that out.
Nakashima with the jab. Dropped down for a low single. But Abbasov removed the leg. Outside leg kick there from James. Drift back to center circle. Inside leg kick from Cameron. One for one on the leg kicks. Champion and challenger. 2:12 remaining. Second of five. Plenty of movement. Neither man flat-footed. Neither a stagnant target. Right hand lead there from Cameron Abbasov. Nakashima plows through with a left hand followed by an outside thigh kick. High single leg here from the Greco-Roman wrestler, the champion, Cameron Abbasov. But Nakashima maintains his vertical base.
Good balance shown by Nakashima right there. He's got that underhook on his right side. He's going to try to fly him up. But a big high crush takedown landed by Abbasov. But Nakashima popped right back up.
Posted on that right arm, which can be dangerous. You always run the risk of popping the elbow up if you defend those takedowns by extending your arm, but Nakashima did it well.
Now that nose is starting to leak from Kiamrian Abbasov.
Well, if it wasn't a target enough after the first round, it's now painted red. Short right hand there. Nakashima edges forward. Mitch, when you are damaged like the champion is at the moment, we know the physical effects, but what about psychologically? You're in the second round, first title defense. Your nose is damaged. Does it take a psychological toll on you?
It can, especially if you start to see your own blood. You know, you made me bleed my own blood kind of thing. But we're also seeing that Abbasov doesn't really seem fazed by it. He's not messing with his nose. He's not pawing at it. There's not really any acknowledgement whatsoever that anything is really, truly wrong. And that's good. He's got a good poker face as well.
Jab. Inside leg kick, late check there from Abbasov. Nakashima slowly, methodically, surely turning up the pressure on the champion. Getting in, getting out, landing on the inside. Nakashima defends against the high kick. James has turned it on in the second round.
10 seconds.
You can see why he's dubbed it Mr. Perfect. Right hand falls short for the champion. Punt kick there.
Stop, stop!
He may be stuck.
Nakashima a slight edge, but Abbasov is doing a lot of good work, doing a lot of, you know, good movement, showcasing a lot of things, like takedown defense going on here. But Nakashima is slowly starting to build. He's starting to build that pressure. He's looking like he's building to a perfect crescendo.
Good check. Step forward. Keep going slow.
The thing with Abbasov is if he decides to put the foot down, if he decides to swarm a couple of punches to the jaw, he can knock out anybody.
Nice little entry on the takedown there. Usually you see more opposite stances, they only go for that single leg, but that time Nakashima shot him for a double leg, but beautiful defense coming from Kiamrian Abbasov as he starts to throw that 1-2.
This is one of the most entertaining welterweight championship matches we have ever seen. Anything could happen at any time. Inside leg, it was a thumper. So too from James Nakashima. You heard the thud of the shin to that femoral profunda. Wild uppercut, almost took out the ring lights there from Abbasov. Nakashima with the jab. Abbasov's hands are dropping a little. He's got to keep them up high. Guard the nose, guard the jaw. Inside leg kick again from Abbasov. One of the key weapons also to use against a southpaw, it's always been the inside leg kick. They are right for it, they are open for it. Of your power leg, your right leg, when you're in orthodox stance.
Beautiful job by James Nakashima to get it finally to the canvas. And he shot in for that single, turned the corner, and put Abbasov down. That's going to score heavily at this point.
Okay, Mitch, here we go. It's changed up. First time on the ground.
Good job by James Nakashima. Now this is where you start to see James Nakashima excel. His topside pressure is something intense.
Now it comes down to wrestler versus wrestler and which style is going to reign supreme.
Greco-Roman against freestyle. You can see Nakashima's trying to posture up, but immediately postures back up. But a beautiful job to spin around, cut through the guard of Abbasov. And now Nakashima's in side control. He likes this position.
What are the key features in freestyle wrestling, Dragon?
A lot of it just comes with the ability to attack the legs, and that's what we're seeing with the takedown attempts coming from James Nakashima, is the ability to shoot in and go after those legs. We're not seeing a lot of those same attempts coming from Abbasov. This is the difference right here. That topside pressure coming from James Nakashima is so intense.
Nakashima looking to pass here. A real tussle on the ground past the halfway point of this contest for the World Welterweight Championship, the greatest world title on the planet. It's held by Kiamrian Abbasov, but Mr. Perfect, undefeated challenger James Nakashima from America wants it. The man who wrestled in college in Nebraska.
Watch that head position come from James Nakashima. He's going to drive that head right underneath the chin of Kiamrian Abbasov and try to keep him flat on his back. He stepped over one. Good job by Kiamrian Abbasov to keep those butterfly hooks. See how he's got his legs on the inside? James is going to keep trying to step over those legs.
The question we've asked for weeks leading up to this one was, how do you find a blemish on a perfect athlete? How do you find a flaw on a seemingly flawless competitor? That is the riddle that Abbasov is trying to solve right now.
See how he's trying to float over those legs? Abbasov is doing a good job of keep trying to slide that knee across the body of Nakashima so Nakashima can't fully take side control. But right now he's got that head, like his left arm controlling the head, which is a bad spot because there's a choke there. If Nakashima can actually get into side control, if Nakashima drives his shoulder into the throat like he's trying to do right there,
let's go improve your position.
Is this how the riddle is solved?
1 minute left in the third round.
He's pinned his arm, Abbasov's arm inside his shoulder like that. There's a choke right there.
Nakashima has the choke on Abbasov, even though it looks like Abbasov has the choke on Nakashima.
Exactly. He's got to apply a lot of pressure, but Abbasov is able to get that arm out.
Wow, great call there from Mitch Chilson. I mean, for me, and I'm sure for most of you watching at home, you thought that it was Abbasov who had the upper hand in that exchange, and he was choking Nakashima. But as Mitch said, it wasn't the case.
It's called a Von Flu choke, Michael.
What's the back of the head?
Especially how Nakashima had his arm pinned in his his side like that, so Abbasov couldn't let go of the headlock. This is that topside pressure that I was talking about. It's just so dominant. Even somebody as big and as strong as Abbasov is having a hard time dealing with this pressure from Nakashima.
The last 10 seconds to hold the welterweight gold was, of course, Ben Askren. Will it go back to the USA again, the welterweight strap? Will it go with James Nakashima?
Man, to get that nose to stop leaking like it was, hats off to the one cut man.
Outside leg kick.
Time! Stop! Here.
So you can hear that.
Yeah. Let's go!
You wonder if Nakashima clean, guys. Will actually crack a smile should he win the gold tonight. It would be well earned, but you cannot write off Kiamrian Abbasov. I'm telling you, folks, it'll take just one swarming flurry forward from Abbasov. Can drop anybody. Nice tuck under there from Nakashima. James tries to tango him back against the wall. Gets there now. Chance for the knees off the right. You see Abbasov defending against that. James tries to lift him. No avail. Little shoulder thrust there.
Yeah, this is Abbasov's world. He likes these upper body clinches, and he's very good at defending these types of takedowns. He's got that overhook or a whizzer on that right side, so he's going to use that to kind of keep Nakashima up so Nakashima can't drop down and start attacking those legs. That's what Nakashima has to do if he wants to get this takedown, is he has to attack those legs.
Popping left hand there. Got some applause from his corner from Nakashima. Calling for a double inside. They want both the arms inside there. Drops down for a double. The corner called for that. You see how Nakashima listens to his corner. And once again, back to center circle. Inside leg kick connects to that femoral profunda. Hurting the lead leg of the champion. You just get the inkling. You get the tingling sensation that pretty soon Abbasov is going to put the foot down, is going to throw helpful leather at James. Uppercut on the inside there from Kiamrian Abbasov. Inside leg kick again from Nakashima. It's prime weapon for him. It is landing every time. And you see, that's another part of the smarts of Nakashima. He knows that Abbasov likes to flurry, likes to swarm with the hands. What's the best way to shut down a boxer, a puncher? Kick out his legs.
But he's also doing a beautiful job of keeping Abbasov on his back foot. He's not allowing him to establish control and really control the circle. He's keeping him on his back foot. I'd like to see him utilize a little bit more of that jab. Just start touching him on the bridge of that nose, because you can see Abbasov is starting to paw at that nose. It's starting to bother him a little bit. Nakashima's got to sense that and turn it up right now.
The heavy breathing you're hearing is Abbasov. Is it a matter of running out of steam, Mitch, or is it a matter of the broken nose, the possibly broken nose, causing him problems and having to breathe through the mouth?
No, he still looks very light on his feet. He's still moving around well. He's not really labored in a lot of his movement, but I do think it's probably the nose. And Nakashima has to go after that. Keep touching with that jab on that nose.
Oh, he's rocked in! He's rocked in! There it is! There it is! Here's Abbasov's opportunity, the high knee! Nakashima in trouble! Here comes the flurry! Here comes the swarm! Here comes Kiamrian Abbasov! Nakashima backed up for the first time! He was rattled! He was shaken! He's still shaking! Oh my! Nakashima!
No, that's it!
Kiamrian!